Hello, good morning student. This is Harshnath Shukla and today in class 10 we are going to discuss lecture number 7. Chapter is triangle and today's topic is areas of similar triangles. So what is the relation between the areas of similar triangles and their corresponding sides? So discuss the theorem number 6.6. So please write down theorem number 6.6. 6.6. So what is the statement? Write down the ratio of areas of similar triangle. The ratio of areas of similar triangles, the ratio of areas of similar triangles are equal to the squares of ratio of squares of their corresponding sides, equal to the square of the ratio of their is equal to the square of is equal to the equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. As suppose ABC, these are the triangle ABC and this is the triangle PQR. So if these two triangles are similar, then ratio of areas of triangles ABC divided by area of triangle PQR is nothing but AB square upon PQ square, or AB by PQ square, BC upon AB by PQ square is equal to BC upon is equal to BC upon QR square is equal to AC upon PR whole square. So this is the statement of this triangle, this particular theorem. What is the statement? The areas of the ratio of the areas of similar triangles is equal to the squares of the ratio of their corresponding sides. As triangle ABC and triangle PQR, if they are similar, then area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is nothing but AB upon PQ whole square, BC upon QR whole square, and AC upon PR whole square. So now we are going to prove this theorem. So let us consider proof. Proof of this theorem. First we make area of triangle PQR and triangle ABC. So suppose this is triangle ABC, this is triangle PQR. Now they are similar. So suppose this is the construction AL, M and P, and these are the perpendiculars on triangle ABC. So first of all, given triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. What is to be proved? To prove area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR, this is nothing but AB upon PQ whole square equal to BC upon QR whole square is equal to AC upon PR whole square. Now construction, this is the step of construction, step of proof construction. AM perpendicular to draw AM perpendicular to BC and PN perpendicular to QR. PN perpendicular to QR. So these are the three steps. Now last step is proof. So how will be proof? So listen. Now last step is proof. Area of triangle ABC. ABC divided by area of triangle PQR. You know very well what is the area of triangle ABC. So area of triangle ABC is half of AM perpendicular into base, or base into perpendicular. So BC upon into AM and divided by half of QR into PM. Half of cancel, so this is BC upon QR and this is AM upon PM into AM upon PM. This is equation number 1. Now if we are able to prove AM upon PM, this is nothing but BC upon QR, then the area of ratios of area of triangle ABC upon triangle PQR is nothing but BC upon QR whole square, and similarly we can do others. So next step, this is equation number 1. Now next step is as you know triangle, as triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR, so angle C is equal to angle R, and this angle AMC is equal to angle PNC each of 90 degree. Okay, so by AA criteria of similarity, so by AA criteria of similarity triangle AMC similar to triangle PNR, so these two triangles are similar. So what we have, if these two triangles are similar, then AM upon PN is nothing but AC upon PR. Okay, AC upon PR, and also we have MC upon NR, so no need to write MC upon NR because we can't need that particular. So by this is the result, AM upon PN is equal to AC upon PR. Why? Because these two triangles are similar. Also we have a BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. So suppose this is equation number 2 and this is 3. So from 2 and 3 you will have AM upon PN is equal to BC upon QR. This is equation number 4 and this is your important equation number 4. Now first you know very well, so from 1st and 4 we have from equation number 1st and 4 we have from 1st and 4 we have what we have area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR, and this is nothing but AM upon PN into BC upon QR. So AM upon PN is BC upon QR from equation number 4. So we put here, so this is BC upon QR into BC upon QR. So area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR, this is nothing but BC upon QR whole square. Okay, similarly other results, similarly we can prove, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR, and this is nothing but BC, then AB upon PQ whole square, and this is also equals to BC, AC upon BC upon QR, then AC upon PR whole square. So from these two results we can write, we have the last result as, required result as area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR is nothing but AB upon PR whole square, BC upon QR whole square is equal to AB upon PQ whole square and equal to AC upon PR whole square. So this is the result. This is this particular term. Now some more theorem based on this. So please try to solve from other books or from NCERT only. You will get the result for other theorems related with the area of the similar triangles. So we had completed this particular theorem. Now some questions based on this, then exercise. So we shall discuss one question here. Exercise 6.4, question number 1. Let triangle ABC, exercise 6.4 question number 1, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. It is given and their areas be respectively, that means area of triangle ABC is equal to 64 centimeters square and area of triangle DEF is nothing but 121 centimeters square. If EF is equal to 15.4 centimeter, then find BC. So very simple, you know the relation last theorem area of triangle ABC, ABC divided by area of triangle DEF, and this is nothing but if you consider BC, so EF BC upon EF whole square. So this is nothing but 64 upon 121. So we have 64 upon 121 is equal to BC upon EF whole square. So BC upon EF is nothing but 64 by 121 square root. So BC upon EF is, BC upon EF is 8 by 11. This implies BC. BC we need to find, and EF is 15.4 8 by 11. So BC is equal to 15.4 into 8 divided by 11. So if we calculate, we'll get this as BC is equal to 1.4 into 8. So this is 8 4s are 32, 8 1s are 1, 3 11. So 11.4. So BC is nothing but 11.2 centimeters. So this is the result. So in this manner, we have to complete area theorem, and then we discuss a question also. So please try to solve the question based on this. And next lecture, Pythagoras theorem and other theorems. So thank you for today. Thank you very much.